Hello, welcome back to this. Welcome back to this. To this new stream. So, currently over the weekend I fixed the font rendering. I fixed the font display. So currently, if we run this, we currently get a image and then the font that is overlaid on top. But now we basically need to worry about text layout. So if I go here, and I can see right in this corner, we are getting the layout that we want, right? And it's just drawing all the numbers on top of each other. So eventually what we want is that we have the rectangle, but there are some things going on that aren't really great. So for example, I've set the size to be 0, 0, but there's still some sort of padding going on. So ideally, this would be right here in the corner. And I'm not sure if this is actually 15 pixels high. Not sure what's up with that. Because, you know, there are still some issues, right? And if we then, we then pad the lines, and we need to make sure, you know, that it actually it should. If we've done this correctly, it should fill all the numbers here, and then it should overflow and show a scroll bar if it's overflowing. But that's a thing that, you know, we need to address. Right? So I've also put a noise gate now on the microphone. I'm not sure if you can hear the difference. Maybe it will make some difference to the audio quality. So, but that's what we want to achieve. And yeah, probably if there are too many numbers, too many textures, if we quit, then probably because there were still things in the pipeline and it couldn't send them because there was a timing issue. So, but we wanted to exit this anyway, so. We need to later on panic on a send error. So, yeah. Later on, we also need to cache the text layout because we can't do all of this all the time. We need to somehow have IDs for the text, right? And yeah. So I don't really want to get too much into this, but well, here we go. So I've made this function called, where is it? I've also translated the parsing function to be a function instead of a macro. Push font. It's just so we don't have an excessive amount of left shift. So, but this is basically what we want. So I've put have this function called. Now I've already done this so that we can actually get the text. So the text is basically we get the arena, we get the data, we get the node type, and if it's a label, then we want the text. Otherwise, if it's a div, we simply do nothing because you know push text doesn't work on divs. The divs are only for like elements. We have a label, and if everything else is basically an error, because because what I want is for these other types, like you know, calendar and button and so on, they should all be divs and labels. Even the image thing is basically just a div with a special rule of with a special CSS rule, right? But that's it, right? There's no distinction between image and a. Now we're going to work this out later because we need to. It's basically sort of monomorphization into the into the actual data node type. So I have to. So we have this function put text in bounds. So we have the text, we have the font, we have the font size that we want, we have the bounds. So let's just create a new file because this is good. This is currently too large. Here we have the lib.rs file. I've also worked on the documentation and I've made some of the modules private because they only contained one or two structs. So we can just directly expose them without, you know, going through all of this. And we don't need a special module for just one struct. But this function into the text layout. So we want to have a left, middle or right aligned text. And so push text style rectstar. So we also want the text alignment. And then we want default for text alignment. We want to align it to the left. And we have the we want a up in display list. Can't find module in display list. display. So now we have the vertical matrix. So let's just see what happens if we say text. What if we do this? Does it actually break the text? Yes. It does. It does, but apparently this is just awful. Clearly something is going wrong. So it does actually break onto multiple lines, right? But what we want is, okay, first things first, we need to determine how many problems we actually have, because if we I don't have this installed. We have this currently. We need to say, okay, we need to see if what we want to do is we want to see how many Save the screenshot. No, just give me the screenshot folder. Okay. Alright. We want to see if this is actually 15 pixels, not something else. Let's so currently 11 pixels. So if we say we want a font that is 15 pixels high, we get a font that is 11 pixels high. So I'm not sure what's up with that. And we also have a padding of the 5 times 4, 5 times 4 pixel, but 5 times 4 pixel. So we have this. We just have these problems. Font is at offset 5.4. We want it to be at 0.0. Font is 11. Pixels high, even though we want it to be 15 pixels high. And then font is 11 pixels high, even though we want it to be 15 pixels high. So yeah, this is basically the problem that we want to solve. And we want to say, okay, horizontal spacing is completely wrong. So now what do we do? First things first, we're going to make this red because I can't see the green really that much. So here we have a text layout. So first we have the lines. And then we want to also align that text alignment. So we then say, okay, what was this? Text align and wrap for So we have this alignment. Align iterator. Maximum number of rows that the before overflow the general line height. This includes the spacing, basically how many pixels type size. Type size. Type scale. All right. Depth scale. Euclid typed type. The one dimensional length. Yes, we only want a length. So then we have a... So this is the line height. And yeah. Input lines. From rect, and here we have a keep bounds from bounds. Bounds. Alignment. Alignment. Bounds alignment and bounds alignment and use rest type font. Font size pixels. F32. Now this could be better, but font size pixel. Font. Alignment, we want a font size in pixel, and then align. Dot divided by equal font size pixels. So font size pixels. Now what we want is font size pixels size font dot size divided by you size dot y. Divided by line height. So here we want to floor. As u size. From bounds, yes. Okay. No fields. Height. Okay. Then we have max rows before overflow. Max. I know you can write this in a shorter way, but it's usually not line height. Font and the font size why don't we just say okay font size pixels because then we don't have to create this whole, font size pixel, font size, font size divided by Euclid length has some now what we want. Okay, so this also, we want only to lay out the lines until the get lifts text. Instance. So we are going to only do the vertical overflow, not any horizontal overflow, because technically we could look at the rect.style and see if, you know, what's the overflow behavior. And then depending on the overflow behavior, we want to later on set if the text is set within the clip or without. So yeah, that's probably let me just set the CSS overflow property. Role hidden auto visible. Role hidden auto visible. Auto means, yeah, well, text overflow. Well, whatever. We're going to need this later on. So, get glyphs, text overflow. But then depending on the actual overflow, you want to have the length. And then, no, we actually can't. We just fill the rect from top to bottom, and then we say okay. And we want to say. Okay, and to say get glyphs. Actually, we want this, but we don't want this. So that we only have one string. unbounds bounds. Bounds, 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 bounds. I mean, we don't need to have the bounds horizontal scale. How many rows we have before we can overflow. Then we have the then we have, yeah, we are just going to render one extra. I mean, we're just going to render one extra line, one extra line, max horizontal width. Equals bounds dot size dot width. Pixel, how many pixels we can go, and then we are just going to say, okay, we don't actually need this sort of stuff, we are just going to the loops in the space of the of the bounds, not of the layer. You need to offset them by bounds.origin to get the correct position. So then we have the front line writer, front line X. Front line X. Front line tab. Yeah, that's just current line X. Let's just make it simple, current line. Just say and we just set them both to 0, 0. So now that we have a writer of X and Y, now that we get the glyphs, from bounds, alignment, font and font size, font, Loops overflow. Then we want the overflow behavior. Text overflow behavior. We want to overflow, and then we want to then we only want to have the screen height. So get glyphs, text, overflow. Then we want to say, okay, default is there is no auto. I mean, you have scroll, you have bit usual is default, and the default for default is default is scroll. Because we want to scroll we want to clip the text and scroll. Hidden is there's no scroll. Visible, it's just visible. So yeah, that's basically alignment. One size default font size to pixels, font size there's no text overflow, and then we have the font size. And then we want to have the rect style. The rect style is really where everything is going down. So we want the what's the rect style? CSS parser. Show a scroll bar by default, but it only when text is overflowing. Never shows a scroll. Doesn't show scroll bar overflows the text. Right. So text overflow, text align. Multi-tab parser. Text overflow. Text overflow behavior. Auto. Auto. title, scroll. Visible, hidden, class, text, overflow, behavior, hidden, hidden. Right, this is why we created this macro, because it does all of these pass text. Align. Text alignment. So text align, center left right, and we don't have justify center left right, center left. Right, wait, do we actually text alignment? Center left. Right, justify is just not used. I mean, come on. Right. Center, left, right, and justify is simply class text overflow. See what the message is. Font size pixels for text and bounds. Font size. Let me just say font size to 0. Exactly. Expected length. Yeah, this should probably, yeah, and we also say, okay, this S parser, overflow behavior auto. Text overflow inbounds. Private type CSS parser text overflow behavior. Wait, why is this? Why do we need this? probably for the CSS rules. Text line. Let's pass on. Yeah. Display list. Rec.style. Text align overflow. So what was this? Yeah, overflow. Just no. Overflow. Box shadow. Pass text overflow and pass text align. So field overflow. Let's just keep this short. now we can run this. Yeah, so now we have this, and which does basically nothing now. Question is, how do we get this to work? That's the, so now we have the overflow, we have the text layout, we have the line writer. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to units per EM. Units per EM. Not sure we need this. Then we want to the glyph instances, text overflow behavior, does this have size? Web render. Abstract. Size type size 2D. Origin, origin bounds dot origin. So bounds dot side of this max. Horizontal width line x max horizontal width. If you know, line right, line writer x set dot. Writer x dot line writer y self dot line writer x equals self dot origin dot x. Then we want to have self dot line writer x plus self dot origin dot x self dot line writer y plus self dot origin dot y. So that now this is basically what we want. And write a Y. Plus save dot font size zero. Origin typed point2d right, so now this should all run. Should run fine. Right. So now we can just say at least the left and right. Currently center won't work, but we just say match match self.alignment center or left, and then we can just say same thing here. Center is currently not center is currently not not working correctly, obviously, but you can say we just say this center or left. If self dot line matter x smaller than 0.0, self dot line matter y plus equals this self dot line matter x equals this would basically print the characters in reverse. But it's not that easy, right? But at least we got the alignment. Not that easy. This would just print the whole words in reverse. So we may need to do this in a post step. Oh, thanks. Maruchandayo. Yeah, so we're currently doing a GUI framework, a graphical user interface. So yeah, this is what we have. Just so you can so you know what we're doing. So this is currently what we have. We have this, so this is a very long text that should break into multiple lines, and we have this, but currently the font is very, very weird, and I don't know why that is. We have several problems. The font should be up here, but it isn't. Then we have the font is 11 pixels high, but we want it to be 15 pixels high. And the horizontal spacing is completely wrong, obviously. So yeah, that's where we currently are. So getting text to work is really hard. We need to, what do we need to do to get this to work? So I would have text align with overflow font family, box shadow width height, and so on. Yeah, we have everything that we need. So now currently we have this text layout. We're just going to ignore the we are just going to ignore the alignment and just say okay. First things first. No, we're just going to make this in a regular for loop in text.chars. That glyphs. That glyphs equal. And we also need the kerning, so let's glyph iterator. Iterator 1. Let's skip 1. So 2. Glyph iterator 2. In glyph iterator 1 dot. Yeah, but we don't want it to end. This is difficult. We don't want the, I could say zip, but then we wouldn't get the last character, because we want to basically have the kerning between the previous and next. So all we can say is we can say peekable, and then we can just say okay, Second one is peekable, so we can say, okay, for char in glyph iterator 1, let next glyph equal glyph iterator 2 dot peek, and then if let sum iterator peak compute the kernel between current char and next char. Put this as char iterator because these are not glyph iterators. And then char iterator 2.next. Obviously, we need to have this mutable. So advance the iterator every time we want to we get a new kerning pair. Otherwise we have the last character. So yeah, we can just say let kerning equals char iterator peak dot end, then next char, then we can say, okay, where is the docs.js roster kerning, pair kerning, pair kerning, Gale, first A, first second. Should we do this font size? But we need to have this. Yeah, we can just say scale. Scale, and then we can say scale uniform font size dot 0. Then we can say okay, map next char font dot sum font dot get the kerning, pair kerning, font size, self.font size, next char, current char, next char, dot unwrap, or 0.0, and then unwrap or 0.0, right. Then we need to advance the char iterator peak. Advance the iterator. I'm not sure if this will work. Self.font. Inter glyph ID is not Yes, next char. Okay, this works. So we just add the kerning. So position glyphs equal right here. And then we basically self dot, we can just say self dot font size now, since it's already a scale. And then we can just say okay. Position glyphs. Then we do all of this. And then we say, okay, let final x equal self.linewriter x plus self.origin x, so the origin of the rectangle. Self dot let final y equals self dot line writer y plus origin dot y plus equals h matrix dot advance width. Then we can say plus kerning, and then we can say here plus kerning final x final y plus the kerning, and then we say, why am I doing this anyway? Then we can say position glyphs dot push, right? Because we need to break, then we can say okay, this is new line, this is a new line. We can then say okay, we want to have the self dot self dot max row before overflow. No, we don't want that. We want the, actually, we need a current line, which we initialize to 0. Then we can say, okay, we increase the current line, and then we can check. Cool, thanks. Then we can say if self.currentLine is larger than self.max rows before overflow, let's just be consistent. Max lines before overflow, max lines before overflow, type point 2D new. Oh, yeah. Final x and final y. Self dot font size Y. Yes, current char dev dot font size dot y. We have to have one offset of the font size, but yeah. I thought this would happen. Then we just we can say. Okay, I thought this would happen. And then you want to have a kerning, and then we want to have a kerning. Let's just keep it simple. I'm sure there's some fancy method for this, but we will run into boring issues with the char iterator. And we don't use this glyphs overflow. But let's check again if this might have fixed the issue we are having with the text overflow with the weirdly positioned glyphs. I'm also not sure why the font size is. No, this does not fix the issue. Let's see how other people are doing. And we can say, okay, text layout source. We need a cursor, but this isn't really. Where does he? We will do a cursor later on. The cursor is different from the actual implementation. Grab. Get text size. Here we have the line infos new, but where do the line infos self line infos new? Line infos new text font size wrap. No line infos text font size wrap. Get position glyphs. Like line info, line texts. So what they are doing is they are breaking the text into lines before the actual layout happens. which is yeah, it's definitely a good thing because you could cache lines later on, but well, for time line text point line reg dot left, but see it does the same thing. Position glyphs extend glyphs for scaled g dot scaled scale map last. H matrix advanced width. Next equals g dot positioned. Just standalone mean. I hate it. This currently has a bug where I can't search using S. The S doesn't work. If I type anywhere else, the S does work. But if I type in here, I can press S and it doesn't work. So it's kind of annoying. Like, I should report this probably, but yeah, I should report this. So previous word start. Yeah, this is needed if we want to have general. If we want to have right to left layout and so on and so forth. So self to given lines. Closed line. No, we don't need all of this. I just want to have regular text. Glyphs for g dot scaled, g dot h matrix, x. Where does x come from? State. Again, none, 0.0. X plus width plus current. Weird thing is, why does the H matrix not work? Yeah, if you want to view more tutorials and so on, I've put them all, I've recorded them all on YouTube. There's a backup actually on YouTube. It's in the description. So not sure what positioned even does. Positioned. Positioned. Shared. Positioned glyph. Position point. Why does he position the glyph? next. Well, so we didn't solve the question of why does the I have to go to lunch, so I don't think I'll get this done before lunch. So could wow, wait, what? What's happening? Oh, it was a weapon in a bug. This sometimes happens, but I don't know why. So we didn't, we can't currently see why we are not having some regular spacing on the font. But what we can see, the counting works. I mean, I don't know if this is actually. Kerning. I mean, I'm not sure if there's any kerning. See, some kerning. There's some kerning in the font. Bit, a bit. 0.3, 0.2, but largely no kerning. Come on. So, yeah, I'm not sure how we are going to solve this. I'm not sure. But I think that's it for now. We haven't really solved anything, but yeah, sometimes that's just the case. Sometimes, you know, you don't. I'll probably have to experiment a bit with this. You know, it could be a bit boring, so I don't want to bore anyone, and I'm going to start the next stream when I've found the solution as to why this font is not displaying incorrectly, and then we are going to go over why the padding is in a certain way. Rust type is sometimes very, very problematic. If you have any questions, just put them in the stream, right? This is more or less the end of the stream now, and I hope you can hear me all well, even though my microphone isn't the best. So, yeah, I hope you all had fun, right? And just to make this short, I'm just going to run this in release mode so that we can see what kind of frame times we're getting. Right. By the way, there's another guy who's currently streaming Rust on Twitch, so yeah, look at this. I mean, come on. 1.2 milliseconds. 1.2 milliseconds frame time. Like, how can you argue that this is slow? Right? You just need to, you know, 1.1 millisecond frame time. Like, this is insanely fast. Right? For all of this that we're doing with box shadows and fancy images and so on and so forth. Like, I mean, On the other hand, it's eating up memory like crazy, but we need to debug this. So yeah, nobody has questions anymore, right? We're just going to end the stream here, and thank you all for watching, and goodbye.